How's everybody? Once again, my name is Mr. Champ Gamer. I'm back with another video here for you guys today. And we got some more Madden 22 Face of the Franchise. We're going to do Challenge the Best and Pro Challenge. So, let's get into that. Week 2 of Progress
Report.
Hey, Jordan,
right? We met last week.
Hey, Jordan. Everyone's talking about you and your client. How are you?
I'm great, thanks. Listen, I know you're busy, but could you give me some intel on how you feel he's doing?
Still in the early phases of development. We just got to rewire his system a little bit so we can get the best performance out of him.
I see. Anything that stands out the most?
Loves to compete. Loves it. He wants to win every drill, every time.
Sounds about right.
But I'm just fine-tuning a few things with him so he can get those results.
Cool.
Listen, do you have any more prospects here for me?
Oh, right now, it's just him. He's the only one I rep, actually, since he's also the only one that gave me a shot. But we're building something different here, and people are taking notice.
It starts with one, and that's all it takes. Listen, I gotta head out to these warm-ups, but if you want to stop by the field...
I just realized he doesn't have a leg.
I'll be there. Would love
that. I've never noticed that.
Definitely. See you then.
See ya.
First time me realizing that. I've never seen that in the game.
Hey, so listen.
Later that week, Mike all access.
I know you got a lot to be looking at in here, but this has been more than a tour. Certain things have lined up, and I thought this would be the best place to let you know. You just landed your first endorsement deal.
Hey.
Welcome to Team Nike. These are your new Nikes. We designed these PE colorways with the three teams that might draft you in mind.
Three teams?
Are you for real?
So that's no Jets, way. Jacksonville, and is it my 49ers?
You're kidding me, Jay. Thank you. Thank you. You out here making these big moves for me.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this is a rare deal. Murray, Barkley, Burrow, and now you.
Where do I sign?
Okay, slow down. We still gotta go over the numbers, but the deal is ours. They believe you're gonna be the leader of this year's rookie class.
Love it.
Pressure, huh? We got this.
It comes with some benefits and opportunities.
Yo, out of all the NFL players who've signed with Nike over the years, my boy's gonna be the first one with his own signature shoe. Hey, tell me I get to design it, though.
What?
You get your style from me anyways, man. You're welcome. Come on, I'll make it look dope.
How about we get Tinker instead?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, actually. Jay, money.
49ers better take me, bro.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Hey, we're just as excited.
Man, this is incredible. Okay, okay. Second week of training here at Nike is in the books, and my
end of week
man is putting
two,
in some extra
training.
Work on his own, because that is how you stay a household name. Speaking of which, since we got the exclusive invite to come out to Beaverton, we've been spending so much time on and off the field with NFL greats. We're talking Pro Bowlers, Hall of Famers, baby. Everything my man here is trying to become, and I gotta say, so far he's looking good. But I'm gonna go on record and say that he's lucky that I ain't out there. Ain't that right, superstar?
Why don't you come out here then?
Nah. See, because what happens if I put this phone down, go to work on you, then there's no proof. And then you can just dismiss it like it never happened. What you do? Hey, why are you picking on me? Just some random guy. Why don't you go one-on-one versus NFL competition, huh? Because I'm sure there's a lot of guys out here who would love to go up against you. Say something.
Dude really got punked in the head. Okay, jersey swap. Nice start to your collection. Check out the yard where you can show off the new gear. All right, Rich Eisen, what do you got for me?
All right, so let's get to the interesting part. Somehow, there isn't any footage of this mythical football game that supposedly took place at Nike HQ. But there are whispers that a certain player from Clemson looked like an absolute star among an exceptional group of pros.
Wouldn't say
and
that.
Pros, I mean all pros and pro bowlers. Yeah, and you gotta believe that every team in the NFL was wishing they'd had some kind of access to that event. I can tell you one thing for sure, though. If we hear anything else about this unicorn of a game, you can rest assured we'll share
it. Guys, we edit avatar. Guess we can add skill point. There we go. Let's do speed. Okay. Extreme effort. After getting out there with some of the best in the world today, it's clear that I've got a lot of work to do. Can you stick around for a bit? I mean, how can I help? Well, that was me talking. Yeah, it's a little different than the colleges, and of course, I'm always happy to help someone on their pursuit of greatness. Let's go mental focus. Okay, so anything in particular you want to work on? Let's go. Yeah, I want to throw under pressure. Hey, you're the boss, mate. I'm just here to assist. Let's get to it. Alright. Work on that. I just keep saying edit avatar. I don't. Not quite sure what this keeps showing me. Oh, hot ground master. No. More of a running gun type of player. Let's do college legacy. Pretty sure we're gonna play in college,
if
right?
If you haven't heard the name Jordan Wright yet,
we three
believe
college
me, you're about
legacy.
To be hearing it a whole lot real soon. She's one of the top young agents in the game, and we're actually live here at Nike headquarters. Jordan, what are we doing out here today?
We're watching the soon-to-be number one pick get some work in.
Oh, so you're calling it right now, huh? You think he's going first overall? That's a wrap?
Of course. I mean, I can't name
he was on Instagram
dominated the way he has.
True, true.
Looks so
I've
realistic.
Been building and building since high school, and every step of the way, he has lived up to it. I mean, everyone's still talking about the college football playoff, and that was a month ago.
Of the college football world have descended upon this grand
Florida Gators versus Clemson.
Tonight, it's the second of our two semifinal matchups in the
flashback. College semifinal in New Orleans, LA.
Clemson Tigers.
All right, boys. Get to work.
For the right to play in next Monday's national championship game in Miami, we are underway here in New Orleans. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And that one taken in by Lassley.
I look like Tim Tebow out here.
As he gets it to the 30. Cool under pressure right there, escaping the pocket and finding what I think was not his primary target.
And some of these guys are just so comfortable getting outside of the pocket that they'll do it on purpose. It doesn't even need to be a breakdown. It's just they move, and they know it affects the defense because a lot of times you get lost in coverage in the secondary, and I think you're exactly right. Wasn't his primary target. Found a secondary guy who sprang open, probably because of his movement out of the pocket.
Pretty solid run here on first down. Almost picked up another first, but he appears to be a few inches short. Second down and inches.
That's why I got the legs.
Taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. We know how important it is, Charles, to have a quarterback
And he just exhibited what he's shown throughout his career, and one of the reasons why they like him so much in today's football, his ability to use his
got him.
And that is caught. Touchdown Clemson from 10 yards out. And Clemson has taken the early lead.
It is so loud.
Something, Charles, that we have seen so much this year from him. A great throw there for the touchdown.
And not only did we just see that throw, it makes you think back throughout the season. You talked about it. We've seen it throughout the year. The variety of throws we've seen from him. We've seen every angle, different platforms, on the move, in the pocket. Does he have to gun it? Does he loft it? He has all the throws in his arsenal, and he just exhibited one more there for another touchdown.
And good hit. Got down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. They begin the drive with Jennings on the ground. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop it.
Oh, okay.
Behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Side. This is Miller. A solid stiff arm. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards.
All right. Second quarter.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw.
Let's go.
And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Can't get away, and he's taken down.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense. Six defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline. They keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing. The O-line coach will.
Great blocking, nearly sprung in there. 28-yard return. And possession will switch hands.
I love 7-0. We got the ball here.
Back out there, ready for their next drive. To the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. He'll drop to throw. Steps away to his left. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. 23 yards on the tuck and run.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
I wasn't watching the clock.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Yep, I want that.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure.
Oh, man.
He's going to throw one up for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown Clemson. Zacharias Thomas in the final seconds of the first half. And Clemson tacks on to their lead. So retract the yardage and retract the touchdown.
And retract the chunk play. Big strike there to get the touchdown. Now they've got to take it back and see if they've got another one still in their arsenal.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone.
Oh.
Going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down. Thank you. The winner goes on, the loser goes home as we start the second half of this semifinal matchup.
I like our chances
here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback. Ready to begin their next drive. Here's the Florida offense. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
On second down. It's Jennings, and he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. To throw, White. And that is incomplete. It appears they're going to come up empty on this first drive.
All right, so a portion of punt
still
here.
Down by that slim margin.
Yeah, and that's okay. You know, when you sit and analyze it, they're not happy about what happened, having to go to the bench. But this gives them a chance to let their defense do some work while they, on the sidelines, go over what they're doing offensively and formulate a proper plan.
And he will finally go out of bounds just shy of the 40. Well, that looked for a second like he might take it all the way, but as it stands, it's still a massive return. And this offense, they're going to have an excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. Now a throw here to his running back, and he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
I like the passing. Oh, man.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it.
Get in.
Receiver complete, and he will score.
Let's
touchdown
go.
Zacharias Thomas, a 22-yard touchdown grab, and Clemson tacks onto their lead.
When we draw up defenses on the board, we do account for every receiver. But in that particular play, somehow he was wide open, became an easy touchdown pass.
Point after, right down the middle, and it's now 14-0. So after the touchdown, Clemson back out there to kick this thing away. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. The Gator offense about ready to get this next drive started. They're staring at
him again.
Deficit 14-0 to score.
So confident, we're at 14-0. Good hit.
He's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play. I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right? Whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it.
And he is going to be taken down. And that should be the final play of this third quarter.
Oh, we're headed to the fourth quarter.
Playing three quarters.
We're all 14-0.
As it looks like we are just about set and ready to begin with the fourth. Now on second and 16, White. And they set up the screen. That's complete. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down. White looks to throw. To the right, complete to Galladay. And he gets this only to the 44-yard line. Not near enough to keep the drive alive. Did they maybe play that too safely on third down? I know you don't want to just throw a ball blindly downfield, but that didn't help him a whole lot.
I think they probably said if it's open, take the shot. If not, get something safe because we do have fourth down.
Intercepted.
And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off at the 28. For this defense, CD, that's kind of the icing on the cake here as we get to the end of this.
And didn't you feel that they weren't just going into total prevent there. You know, they have the lead, and sometimes you fall back and you lose your aggressiveness. Not in this case. They were still making a play on the football, and look how that one turned out. They may have salted this one away.
The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. He finds an opening past the 40. There he goes, right side. And he will take this in for a Clemson touchdown.
Oh,
there are any scouts in the building wondering about his arm strength. I mean, wonder no more. That was a heck of a throw.
You put that one on tape, as they like to say all the time when you talk about the best players. Just watch the tape. Things get confirmed. That was a laser shot. Absolute rifle. Bam. Puts it right on it.
Pretty much over.
Just stand back and applaud.
So after the touchdown, Clemson back out there to kick this thing away. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Ready to begin their next drive. Here's the Florida offense. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one
reason.
Got
it. Let's go.
Comes and down he goes. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Throwing on second and long. White. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. Now another timeout called for by the offense.
Over mode.
So talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now White.
Let's go.
In trouble, and he's taken down. And no move to get the offense off the field. Despite failing once, they're going to go again here on fourth down. He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over.
Let's go,
they had to go for it with such little time remaining. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. Second and 11 now. He'll decide to keep this once more. Powers through it.
Oh, my God.
And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Now we'll get whistles, and they've signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he's going to be dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. So led by a collective team effort.
Let's go. 21-0. Draft stock trending up. All right.
Well, we're now just a few days away from the college football playoff championship game, where one of the nation's top quarterbacks will take the field one last time in a Clemson Tigers uniform. Now, there's no question his career speaks for itself, but you can bet that NFL scouts, coaches, and players will be tuning in to see how he performs when the lights shine brightest. And believe me, he knows as well as anybody, this is the last chance to not only add to his legacy, but further solidify his place as a top pick in the NFL draft. And speaking of the draft, we'll be joined in a moment by NFL insider Ethan Rhodes. He's got some interesting tidbits he's picked up over the last week.
Okay, so that being said, I'm going to get out of here. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like this video, hit that like button. Subscribe now if you haven't already yet. Become a champion today. And I'll see you guys in the next one.